Reading a scholarly article is different than reading a novel. You don't have to read every word from beginning to end, at least not to start with. I'm going to walk you through how I read a scholarly article in order to help you increase your comprehension while saving you some time. Before you begin reading, be sure you have a clear topic statement or research question in mind. Mine is, how do social networking sites like Facebook and YouTube contribute to bullying in schools, and how can this situation be prevented? Here I've identified some search keywords which I've used to find a scholarly article in an EBSCOhost database. The article I've chosen is called Parental Mediation, Online Activities, and Cyberbullying, written by a researcher named Mesh, and this is from the journal Cyberpsychology and Behavior. Let's open up the full text of this article and have a look. The first step is to read the abstract. This is a summary of the article which will help me to decide if it's relevant to my topic. This article is a research study on a fairly new topic in the field of psychology. It looks like they've found that parenting is an important factor in cyberbullying. By the way, it's good to make note of key terms like cyberbullying that the professionals are using. This term could be useful for future searches. Based on the abstract, I can see that this article may help me answer my research question, so I'll go ahead and have a closer look. Rather than reading this 9-page article word for word, I'll start by reading the introduction. I'll just let my eyes scan quickly over the sentences, looking for key ideas. I may want to paraphrase or quote these ideas later, so if I were reading this in print, I would highlight or underline them. I also note that the author frequently refers to other research studies. This is common practice in scholarly literature. The author is providing me some context by summarizing what else has been published on his topic. If I wish, I may look up his cited articles later on. Here he gets into parental mediation, one of his main points. He also points out the potential flaws in his study, which gives him points for honesty. Still, this article went through the process of peer review, so I can be pretty confident of his findings. Speaking of findings, there are some key sections that are typical of research articles like this. We've seen the abstract and introduction. You'll also find a conclusion section near the end. It may be called something else. In this case, it's called discussion. But it basically tells us what the researcher discovered in doing his study. I'm going to skip to this section right now. Remember, we're not reading a novel, so it's okay to peek at the ending. Some of Mesh's findings sound interesting to me, so I'll highlight or underline them. Since he's piqued my curiosity about rules for visiting websites, I'll go back to the results section to read his findings in more detail. He goes into a lot of statistics, which is typical of a research study. Sometimes I'll read the narrative discussion of the results, but sometimes I'll glance first at a stats table to get a quick visual overview. For instance, I quickly noticed that kids with more highly educated parents weren't necessarily less likely to be bullied. I can read the narrative description to find out why. Ah, here's where he talks about parental rules and how they seem to have a beneficial effect. I'll probably read the results in more detail, but I should point out the methods section. This section will tell me what kind of research the author did, a survey in this case, how it was conducted, and details about the participants. After discussing the results of his study, the author recommends further research that his colleagues in the field may want to do. Finally, don't overlook the references section at the end. This isn't just here to impress you with how much Dr. Mesh has read on this topic. This list and the accompanying footnotes allow you to read on this topic in more detail if you wish. That's part of the scholarly process, helping others learn while advancing the level of knowledge in one's field of study. So, having read through this article for just a few minutes, I believe I have some excellent material to quote or summarize in my research paper. Of course, I may want to go back and read this article from start to finish, but by knowing what sections to look in and having a clear research focus, I've saved myself some time and have gotten some good results. If you need further help finding scholarly journal articles, please view the appropriate video tutorials or contact the librarians at the reference desk.